the waters of baptism, cast them down with the Christ and rose to new life, may she now share eternal glory. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
we're gathered here in God's presence, here in God's house, at St. Patrick's Church, to pray for the repose of the soul of an obviously very, very popular woman, Catherine Squires. We ask God to welcome her through the gates of heaven, home into eternal life. We also pray for you, the family, and many, many friends who mourn her passing. God will give us a sense of faith which reminds us that we come from God and our destiny is to be with God. And so Catherine is going home to God. And by our Mass today together, all we're doing, we hold Catherine close and carry her through prayer and offer her back to God, our loving Father. So we first pause, place ourselves in God's presence. We ask for God's blessing upon us all, an eternal life upon Catherine. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant Catherine also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for our first reading, and that's by Richard.
A reading from the book of Aeschylus. God has made everything suitable for its time. For everything there is a reason and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born, a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to throw away stones, and a time to gather up stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to throw away, a time to tear, and a time to sow, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time to war, and time for peace. God has made everything suitable for its time. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
And our psalm is by Linda.
The response to the psalm is, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want."
The Lord
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me along the right path, he is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff, and these you give me comfort.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil, my cup is overflowing.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
And our second reading by Erica.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Love does not come to an end. Be ambitious for the higher gifts, and I am going to show you a way that is better than any of them. If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn, but I'm without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offence. And it is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand for the gospel acclamation. The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I'm going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return and take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I'm going." Thomas said, "Lord, we didn't know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated, thank you. A I'm sure I speak on behalf of us all here today when I say our love and our thoughts and prayers very much with all of Catherine's family and her many friends at this sad time. And remember especially her daughter Katie and son-in-law Richard, her granddaughter Sophie, siblings Linda, Margaret and Sean, Pauline and Peter. I must say I feel very privileged and even proud that I can be the priest today for Catherine and her family and friends. I know she's been very much a much loved and respected member of this parish for many years, and that's reflected by the number of people who are in church for her funeral. But I won't say too much myself about Catherine, as very shortly her daughter Katie is going to come forward and share with us the eulogy, and she'll tell us more about her mum. See, the personal things of Catherine and her life, the one who knew her best, her own daughter. But I would like to say, though, that I was very moved when Katie phoned me a few weeks ago to say, would I please go and see her mum and give her the last rites. So I called her Kirkland on a Thursday evening a couple of weeks ago, and Catherine was very aware of who I was and why I was there. And she was lovely and very chatty and smiling. And she even said to me, I know I'm dying, but I'm not afraid. I gave her the last rites, and she really was very peaceful. Then I called again the next evening to see her again. And this time she wasn't conscious, but still very peaceful. And I must say also that she was surrounded throughout with the love and presence of her own family, who never left her side. I must say it was a great honour to be there with them. I could see how special Catherine is and how loved she is by her family. Just first now say a few words about faith. A faith Catherine believed and loved and practiced here in St. Patrick's Church for many years. A faith I hope can bring us some comfort and strength on a day like today. Because faith reminds us that Catherine has moved on. Her life on earth is complete. Her work is done. It is now her turn to take her place of rest in our true eternal home of heaven. And although we are sad today, that's very natural. We miss her in many ways. Let's try and remember her with a smile and thank God for the gift that God gave us in Catherine's life. So think about her and talk about her. Keep her memory alive in your own lives. She can live on in your lives as well. Because death is nothing to be afraid of. It's simply a part of life. We saw this last week in Holy Week, but Jesus gave his life on a cross that we might have eternal life. Jesus showed through his cross that death is our gateway to eternal life. And so this is our faith and our hope today for Catherine. As our psalm said today in the very last line, in the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. That is our faith, that is our hope, and that is our destiny. Jesus, in whom Catherine had faith, is now ready to take Catherine home. And we know therefore that we shall see her again. Death is not going to have a last say. Death is not going to be an everlasting parting. God will have the last say. And so with faith and hope, this is now the start of her eternal life. She can be reunited with all her loved ones who have gone before her. And together they can enjoy the eternal life of heaven. And then one day, in God's own time, we too hope to join them in our true eternal home of heaven. So again, we thank God for her life. which had now returned from where she came in the very beginning. She came from God, and she's back with God. Those who've died in Christ go no further away from us than God, and God is always very close to us. So now I'm going to invite Katie Ford, please, to share with us the eulogy about her mum.
Welcome to all of you, and as a lot of you will know, I am Katie, Catherine's daughter. My mother would have been so overwhelmed and honoured to see that you all could make it here today to celebrate her life, so thank you. I also want to add that it was also your continued support, showering of love and prayers which were so valuable to her and us in her final weeks and days. Fiercely independent, good sense of humour, private, kind, a passion for history, a passion for gardening, loyal and selfless. Catherine Nora Squires, also affectionately known as Cathy, Sissy, Grandma and Mum, was born on the 21st of June 1958 in the front room of 181 Church Lane to Mary and Sydney Squires. She was one of six children and the fourth youngest in her family. Linda, her eldest, then Sean, Margaret and finally Pauline and Peter, the two youngest. Each and every one of her siblings had a very special place in her heart, and I know that a part of them all has now gone up with her to Grandma and Grandad. Faith, of course, was at the heart of the Squires family, being raised the Irish Catholic family that we were. Attending St. Patrick's Church and building a very special family bond with the nuns of our parish, Sister Gemma and Sister Pat, whom our family have always cherished. My mum passed that faith on to me, and until the very last moment, including the very special time she spent with Father Eamon, had unwavering faith in God and what was to come. She took great comfort in knowing what was to come. In her darkest times, she always told me to have faith in God's plan. Like all of her siblings and me, she attended St. Patrick's Catholic Primary School, which is where her mother, my grandma, was cook, and also where she attended with her very good friends, Margaret Travis and Julie Healy, who she remained close with until the very end. Judith Vickers was also another very special friend and a real character, whom she missed dearly after losing her a few years ago. She then attended Margaret Clitheroe's, where she flourished and blossomed in the roles which she took on. I could talk for hours about Tales of High School, but one comment that has always resonated with me was about her being a prefect and always watching out for others, no matter what. Her uncompromising integrity and honesty have proven to be among the most valuable guides for myself in my professional and personal life. And whenever I have faced a situation which I have been unsure of, I always ask myself the question, what would my mother do? This desire to protect others led her to joining West Yorkshire Police Force on the 14th of February 1977. This was where she found her calling. This was where she was meant to be. At the age of 22, she was only the third female officer in West Yorkshire on the beat, in no other place than here, Birstall. She also went on to work at Dewsbury, Morley, Rothwell, Holbeck and finally Huddersfield in her final years of service. Information regarding my mum's service as a police officer was something my friend informed me of only the other day. My friend's father, Peter Smith, worked briefly with my mum and is a member of the retired police officer's Facebook page, which many of you in here are on, I know. He said that he was overwhelmed with not only the quantity of comments about my mum, but the sentiment regarding the messages, all complimenting on her natural talent for detective work, but also what a lovely lady she genuinely was, a remark that has definitely been a running theme over the past few weeks. During her time at Dewsbury Police Station, she met her lifelong friend Carol, and at Holbeck, Erica, whom of which she has remained friends with until her death. Parties and holidays were a huge part of their friendship, and I recall one particular holiday when we had just spent a long time assembling a tent and my mum had to move the car and she reversed straight onto the tent. At that point, the air was blue from Erica shouting, "Kathy, Kathy, what you doing?" with some select choice words added in there. Her remarkable gift of policing, especially detective work, resulted in her successfully joining the CID at Wakefield Westgate in 1988. It was here where her determination and natural ability of detective work came to fruition, and eventually, in August 2000, the International Crime Squad, where again, so I hear, she was highly regarded by her fellow officers. Aside from her career, family was so important to Catherine, and always was. She remained living with my grandma and her siblings following the death of her father in 1981. Family was always everything to Mum. She would do anything for them, even sell her soul to the devil himself, and on some occasions I think she actually did. She loved being an auntie, sister, sister-in-law, and a very special friend, and cherished all those in her life in the past and present. For me, she was the most selfless person I have ever met in my whole life. She always put others before herself, even taking on the role as carer of her brother Peter for 24 years following the death of my grandma in June 2000. In 1982, Katie Frances Squires, me, was born. I cherish every moment with my mum, as we really did do everything together until the very end. I was her world and she was mine. She gave me nothing but unconditional love and life experiences, which have undoubtedly made me the person I am today. My childhood was incredible. And looking around this room, I see a lot of friends who spent a lot of time with me and my mum in that back garden. And we have some very, very special memories. My childhood was filled with love and excitement. She took me all over the world, from New York to Rome to Paris to the Yorkshire Dales, always wanting to show me new and great adventures. And boy, did she. Now, perfection is a word that is often thrown around so very easily and so carelessly, and is very rarely really achieved. But that lady, right there, was the closest thing to perfection I've ever come across. She would work all day, all night, come home, and even when feeling exhausted, would get changed and take me to dancing or horse riding. She sacrificed everything for me, even a social life. In 2007, she gained the son she never had, to quote my mother. My husband, Richard, who could never do any wrong in her eyes, and those two buddies always ganged up on me. Finally, in 2014, her little treasure, her only grandchild, Sophie, was born. She was devoted to her. Their bond was endless, and Sophie definitely kept her young at heart, from doing gymnastics in the garden to rolling down a grassy hill. She could turn a rainy day into a grand adventure, read books and sing lullabies. And when I asked Sophie just this week what she misses most about her grandma, she answered, "I loved it when she picked me up from school, and then we would go to Oakwell Hall. And I don't know, I really don't know what I'm going to do when I'm bored now." Her love and unwavering patience will be greatly missed by Sophie, but it is very clear that she has left a piece of her heart and soul with her. And wherever Sophie goes, so will Grandma. And as I draw near to the end of this eulogy, I want to say again how touched and moved I truly am and have been at the outpour of love from so many for such a very special lady, including the lovely staff and wonderful staff at Kirkwood Hospice, who adored and showed my mum so much love and care, and myself and my family. In all sincerity, I'm in peace has stood here, and I know so many more of you are too. But I know that a heart that's broken is a heart that's been loved. I hope that I see the world as you did, Mum, because I know a life with love is a life that's been lived. You were an angel in the shape of my mum, and I'm so glad that you got to see the person that I've become today. Now, spread your wings, Mum, Kathy, Grandma, Sissy, because I know for a fact that when God took you back on that Monday afternoon, he said, "Hallelujah, Catherine, you're home."
You've done your mum proud. Good for you. Well done. Please stand for our bidding prayers, and I invite Mary forward now, please, for the bidding prayers. If a God will come into this world, as God will return when we leave it, comforted by this faith, we turn to God our Father in prayer.
We pray for Catherine. May she be welcomed through the gates of heaven and into eternal life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all her family and friends who mourn her passing. May they be comforted by faith in the resurrection of our Lord Jesus to eternal life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all our families and friends who have died. May they all be at rest now in heaven and be there to welcome Catherine home. We remember especially all those we know and love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for a few moments in silence for our own personal and private intentions. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We turn to Mary, the mother of Jesus, and ask her to pray with us and for us, as together we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear our prayers and grant all of our needs. Call Catherine home to in heaven and strengthen us, your children, with faith. We make these and all of our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated now and we'll sing our offertory hymn whilst the gifts are brought from the back of church. Pray, my dear friends, as my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept
Look favourably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant, Catherine, may be taken up into glory with your saints, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel down or sit down if it's easier. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, grace to make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as you celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and descent into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her husband, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with St. Catherine, and with all the saints, upon whose constant intercession, in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servants, Francis our Pope, and Marcus our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember Catherine, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he'll raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To all our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you'll wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow upon the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. The blood of Christ. Amen. For those who are at home, we now pray the prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacraments. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. We're now going to receive Holy Communion. We have a system in church here at St. Patrick's, so just for each section, please come out on this side and go back on that side. Come out this side, back on that side. About this side, go back on that side, and this side, come out here and go about there. If you'd rather have a blessing, you say you want to come for a blessing, you can fold like this to avoid any confusion. So for communion on the hand or the tongue, if you wish, or for a blessing, just do this so I know what to do to avoid any confusion. So as I say, please come down when you're ready for Holy Communion or for a blessing. Thank you. invite Emily Gott, one of Katie's colleagues at school, who's going to come forward now, read with us for us a poem called Footprints. Thank you, Emily.
Footprints in the sand. One night I had a dream. I dreamed I was walking along the beach with the Lord. Across the sky flashed scenes from my life. For each scene, I noticed two sets of footprints in the sand, one belonging to me and the other to the Lord. When the last scene of my life flashed before me, I looked back at the footprints in the sand. I noticed that many times along the path of my life, there was only one set of footprints. I also noticed that it happened at the very lowest and saddest times in my life. This really bothered me, and I questioned the Lord about it. Lord, you said that once I decided to follow you, you'd walk with me all the way. But I have noticed that during the most troublesome times in my life, there is only one set of footprints. I don't understand why. When I needed you the most, you would leave me. The Lord replied, "My precious child, I love you and would never leave you. During your times of trial and suffering, when you see only one set of footprints, it was then that I carried you."
Let us stand and pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Catherine, for whom we have celebrated these Paschal sacraments, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just for the final prayer of accommodation, just say one thing on behalf of the family. There's going to be a collection today in memory of Catherine for the great work of Kirkwood Hospital, or the Kirkwood as it's called these days. So as leaving church today, you find a basket at the back of church for the Kirkwood, who took such good care of Catherine and also all of their residents, all their patients who were there at such a critical time in their lives. So please give generously to a wonderful organisation like the Kirkwood in memory of Catherine. Before we go our separate ways, we take leave of Catherine. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. First, I'll sprinkle holy water, a reminder of Catherine's baptism, which is first given the promise and the pledge of eternal life. With our incense, a mark of respect for Catherine, Our love and our prayers go with her to eternal life. May the choirs of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to paradise. May the Lord enfold you in his mercy. May you find eternal life. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend Catherine, in a sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to Catherine and help us who remain to come to each other with assurance of the faith until we all meet in Christ and die with you and with Catherine forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto Catherine, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. And may her soul, the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In peace, we take Catherine to a final place of rest, and we sing now our final hymn.
I see the sun. You're so long.